For the past 4 weeks, Juli and I have had the pleasure of staying and working on a permaculture farm here in the mountains of West Java. So today, I wanted to share a little about what life was like and what we learned staying in this wonderful place. By the way, Juli and I use Portuguese and English. So if you're never sure what we said, just double check that subtitles are turned on. The farm we are staying on is called Pedasan Farms, and it is located in Sukabumi Regency in West Java. And yeah, it's very countryside, but our first impression when we arrived was seeing how nice the actual farm was. The building space was really new, the dormitories are really nice and put together, and there are some buildings for guests to stay at as well. During our first week here, we met Reisha, another of the volunteers, who was Indonesian and could speak English and the local languages, like Indonesian and Sundanese.
Obrigada, Reisha. Foi muito bom ter você aqui conosco. Nós aprendemos bastante com ela. Ela nos ensinou bastante sobre a cultura indonesiana e nos ajudou a comunicar com os trabalhadores aqui da fazenda que não falam inglês. Ter ela aqui na nossa primeira semana nos ajudou muito.
Some of the other people here do speak English, like the farm manager Rio and his wife Yuni, and we've been able to talk to them about what it's like to live in Indonesia, the culture, the religion, and things like that. During that first week, we also started working here on the farm, which mostly meant cutting up bits of banana leaf to make some lazy compost using banana circles and cassava.
Quase cheia.
Agora vamos colocar um pouquinho de verdes. Agora vamos encher de vegetação. Cobrir o buraco. Nice.
Then, in the afternoons, it was usually pretty rainy, so instead of working in the garden, we helped out in the kitchen or helped prepare the rooms for guests to stay.
Na nossa segunda semana aqui na fazenda, a Reisha, voluntariada indonesiana, partiu, mas logo no dia seguinte chegou a Liz, de Nova York, que depois passou as outras três semanas junto conosco.
At this point, we were starting to get into the flow of life here on the farm and got a little bit bored of doing composting, but we're still enjoying our time here. By the end of our second week here, we had also seen a few different groups of guests come through, mostly people from Jakarta, including some families and some yoga groups.
O trabalho aqui no dia de semana é 3 horas de manhã, ajudando na fazenda, e depois do almoço, mais 3 horas trabalhando. No fim de semana, quando tem os hóspedes aqui, nós ajudamos na cozinha, servindo ou recepcionando eles, ajudando.
Also, around that time, Ramadan started, so we haven't really had any more guests since then, since most people go home to spend time with their families during the holidays. So, since then, we've been finding some other little projects to work on here on the farm, including making some nesting boxes for the chickens and building some little tools like a fruit picker.
E não só na composteira, nós também limpamos algumas camas para plantar novos frutas e vegetais.
Por alguns dias nós colhemos todos os matos que estavam em volta daqui da plantação e aqui já está nascendo a semente que plantamos, de rosella. É um tipo de fruta, eu não sei direito, nunca comi, mas essas daqui, aquela ali do meio, são rosellas e alface. Plantamos aqui e já estão nascendo. Oh, e com essas na hortelã basil, fizemos pesto de basil, uma delícia.
And picking some fun things like peanuts, which we could then turn into our own peanut butter, which was a long process, but really fun to do.
Yeah.
E muitos amendoins, muito, muito. Qualquer cantinho que tem a cama para plantar tem amendoim. E colhermos bastante, preparar para a próxima estação para plantar. E fizemos pasta de amendoim, que ficou uma delícia.
Of course, on our days off, we also had a chance to go out and explore the area around us.
Fomos conhecer essa linda cachoeira e no outro dia fomos nadar no rio.
It was really beautiful and a good chance to go swimming and cool off. Also, on one of the weekends, the owner of the property came to stay here. So we got to talk to them a little bit about how they acquired the piece of land and their goals and plans for it, which was really interesting. And that basically brings us to today. But since the main reason that Juli and I are traveling the world in the first place is to find a piece of land like this where we can build our own farm, we've been thinking a lot about the things that we like here, the crops that we'd like to grow, the style of buildings and activities we'd like to do, and about the things that we don't like as much. So let's take a look around the farm and talk about some of those little details. The first thing we really like about this place is the space, especially spaces like this. This is the yoga deck where we've been actually doing yoga almost every day and where we can hang out, relax, watch some movies at night and just enjoy the view.
E daqui dá para ter a visão da propriedade. Ali fica os animais, os carneiros, cordeiros e as galinhas. Ali tem as duas casas para os hóspedes. E lá em cima, no topo, é a primeira casa daqui do proprietário, a casa do Minky. E ali atrás é a cozinha onde todo nós comemos. E embaixo da sala de jantar tem o nosso quarto, o dormitório para os voluntariados.
And probably my favorite part of this space is just this little mini library here with just fun books, but also some really, really interesting books on things like permaculture design and architecture. So this is really inspiring.
Aqui na cozinha é onde eu senti comunhão com as mulheres, principalmente, porque elas dizem aqui que os homens não podem entrar na cozinha. Mas aprendendo, vendo elas como cozinhar, e eu fiquei fascinada como eles cozinham cada alimento. Bastante alimentos aqui parecido com do Brasil, tipo muita mandioca, mas o jeito que eles preparam é totalmente diferente. Aprendi várias receitas aqui que futuramente eu quero fazer quando tivermos a nossa fazenda.
Pretty much everything else is out in the garden, so let's go check it out. This is probably the crop that I'm most excited to start planting. This is cassava, which, if you don't know, is also what we use to make tapioca, which I'm sure you do know. Cassava here, as you can see, grows on basically a giant slope, and it kind of just grows anywhere. Now, actually processing and using cassava is a little bit of work, but the results are definitely worth it. If you've never had deep-fried cassava, I recommend going to your local market and buying some and trying it out. It's super delicious. And sometimes cassava just decides to start growing on its own, like this little guy here. Now, one crop that we're not really sure we're going to plant, although it would be fun to try, is rice, like down here. It's a lot of work and maybe not that much of a product. So We're not sure if it's really worth it, but it does look beautiful and taste very good once you get the product.
E precisa de muita água.
Yeah. And you need to build all these structures to keep the water flowing.
Quando chegamos aqui há 4 semanas atrás, eu estava muito animada para comer o maracujá. Tava tudo florido e eles estão crescendo, mas ainda não está na hora de comer. Mas hoje a Amy pegou um que estava pronto e foi uma delícia.
One more thing that Julie and I have talked a lot about already is doing more aquaculture, and they do have a pond set up here, which is in bloom right now, really pretty, and some fish down in there, but we didn't really interact with it in any way. It's kind of already just set up doing its thing. Yeah, I would like to know a little bit more about how to get one of those started. I also really appreciate the animals here. We have loud geese and chickens. And they know that I usually bring them food already. Also, while we were here, some of the sheep gave birth, and a couple of them gave birth to twins. Hi, guys. And one of the mama hens gave, well, hatched a bunch of little chicks, although she's very protective of them. One other thing that we've realized from being here is that when we are looking for our own piece of land, we should probably avoid big hills. The view can be incredible, but it does make actually farming it and walking up it a little more difficult. One thing I noticed pretty early on that is really important is maintaining your paths. Paths like this, with nice, soft, round stones, are really easy to walk on in the rain, at night, just anytime. And it invites people to go explore that part of the area. However, when the paths are not really well laid out or get just a little too much dirt and gravel, it can be kind of a pain to walk them, and that means that visitors or volunteers are less likely to go in those places. So, yeah, I'm realizing how important a well laid out path actually is. And one idea that we really want to implement in our own farm someday, although we didn't really get to use it here, is a space like this with a big fire pit down below where people can hang out, maybe camp up above, and use the restroom and the little cooking space as well. Also, something that's really important to think about when designing the space is building little microclimates like this, where the taro, this is, by the way, taro, it's huge, where the taro shades out this area and creates a nice little cool spot to hang out, even if it's really hot and sunny out in the rest of the garden. Also, spending this past month in the tropics has taught us quite a bit about the kind of place we are looking for to start our own farm. For example, living in the tropics is really nice for fresh fruit and lots of different plants all year long, but every afternoon, it's probably gonna rain.
Para mim, mesmo chovendo, eu amo frutas tropicais e eu adoraria morar em um lugar que tem variedade de frutas para comer o ano inteiro. Colhendo do pé, mamão, goiaba, muitos abacate.
However, at the end of the day, I think we probably learned the most, not out in the garden at all, really. We probably spent the most time here in the community space, where we eat dinner, hang out, play games, talk, and relax. This is the space that probably inspired the most for my thoughts about what we want in the future and what we're going to be doing next. This is where we talked a lot about what was happening in the farm and what we should be doing for the future. And yeah, it's just a great open space where we can feel like part of a community and part of our environment at the same time. Which brings me to kind of the final thing that I think is really important. Our biggest takeaway from this experience is how important it is to build a sense of community in your place. And that involves lots of things, but important things like communication and shared information, shared passion, is all something that really should be thought about along the way and as part of the process of building a space like this.
Esse é o nosso primeiro longo voluntariado. Ficamos aqui por 4 semanas e não sabíamos se íamos gostar ficar tanto tempo no mesmo lugar, na fazenda remota da cidade, mas nós gostamos muito de cada momento que passamos aqui.
Which is why we are thinking about changing our plans a little bit. We are now much more interested in going and traveling not just to other countries and other cities, but to other farms like this and learning as much as we can about the local place, people, culture, food, and how they make it. So even though we're gonna be doing a lot of travel videos, hopefully we'll be staying in a lot more of these types of farms. And when we're there, we weren't really planning to do something like this for this one. But in the next one, we will definitely be more conscious of showing more of the details in our videos. But for now, this is our final night here on the farm. So we are gonna get packed, get ready, and at 5:30, 5:20 in the morning, we are going to be heading back down the hill and off to Jakarta. And from there, we'll be traveling to Singapore and onward to Malaysia after that. So,
thank you for watching and see you at our next destination.
Ciao.
Ciao. Obrigada.